Today we'll be taking a topic of standard 11th, that is accounting concepts. First, what do we mean by accounting concepts and why do we have these accounting concepts in accounts, that we'll discuss. Accounting concepts means whenever any transaction comes in the market, accountant should know how to record them in the books. So for that, ICAI issues various accounting concepts. In total, we have 11 accounting concepts that gives us a clear idea about how to record a particular transaction and where to record. Like we have trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet. Some of the transactions are recorded in trading account, while some are recorded in balance sheet. So how do an accountant get an idea about where to record what? That is based on these accounting concepts. In total, out of 11 accounting concepts, today we are going to discuss these three accounting concepts, that is going concern, consistency, and accrual. These three are called fundamental accounting concepts. What do we mean by fundamental accounting concepts? These are the three accounting concepts which came first in the market. All the accounts were written on these three accounting concepts. So they are called fundamental accounting concepts. Out of that, first is going concern. What do we mean by going concern? Going concern means whenever we write, make book of accounts, we have an assumption that business will go on for many more coming years. So all the transactions are written on the basis of going concern. That is, my business will flourish for many more coming years. Like we can say, suppose I have purchased a fixed asset. So I have an assumption, I'll use that asset for coming 5 to 10 years. So what I'll do, I'll start charging depreciation on that particular asset and I'll record it for 10 years. So that after 10 years, I'll buy a new machine, I'll record accordingly. So that is based on going concern. Same way, many of the expenses we pay in advance, like we pay advertisement expense for coming 5 years. Why do we do that? Because we have an assumption that our business will go on for many more coming years. That is going concern. Clear? So, but there are some places where this going concern concept is not applicable. In total, there are four such circumstances where this concept is not applicable. First one, when business is going to liquidify in some time, when business was opened with a particular objective and that objective is accomplished, business will close down. So they won't make their accounts based on this concept, that is going concern. Third one, when business is going in losses and that unit is declared to be sick, again there also this concept will not be applicable. And last one, already company is in a process of liquidation, a liquidator is appointed, then also this going concern will not be applicable. Clear with this concept? So basic example in this is, we charge depreciation on fixed assets, we pay expenses in advance, we pay deferred revenue expenditures. They are based on this concept, going concern. Now we'll move to the next one, that is consistency. As the name suggests, consistency means something consistent. Every time we do in the same manner, that is called consistency. Well, basically this concept is applicable in case of calculating your inventories and other one in case of calculating your depreciation. What do we mean by inventories? Inventories means closing stock. Whenever we calculate closing stock, there are ample of methods available. We can go by FIFO, we can go by LIFO, we can go by weighted average method. But which method will apply based on assumption of our industry? But whatever method you apply, you have to apply it consistently. Suppose I am applying FIFO, that is fixed, that is first in, first out. So every year for the stock, I'll apply the method FIFO. Or if I have taken LIFO, I have to go with LIFO every year. So this is called consistency. Same way for depreciation, we have 10 methods available. Out of that, suppose I am using SLM, I am using straight line method. So every year for the same asset, I have to use SLM. This is called consistency concept. Now let's move to the third one, that is accrual. Accrual means outstanding. If any of the expenses are outstanding, still we record in books of accounts based on this concept. Suppose I'm paying salary next month on 3rd. Suppose for Jan, I'll pay Jan's salary on 3rd Feb. So same way, in March salary will be paid in April, but books of accounts get closed in March. But still, in our books of accounts, we'll record the salary of March, though we have not paid that. We are going to pay in April, but we'll record that on the basis of this concept, that is accrual concept. Am I clear with all the three? First one was going concern, second is consistency, third is accrual. All these three are called fundamental accounting concepts. Still, there are 8 more that we'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.